We did not want that. Oh, it's gonna rain all day tomorrow. That's fun. Haha, Zextro, you missed it. I already ate my sandwich. Can't have it. Oh, Robin's lost axe. We'll take care of that. I gotta remember that I'm not upgraded yet. Depressing. But we have our cool farm, which is awesome. I really want to make an orchard because we didn't really plant many fruit trees in my last LP, so I want to kind of make that a priority. Once I have more money, obviously. Not right now, but eventually we'll do that. I haven't decided who I want to marry yet before anybody asks. Still thinking about it. I kind of wish we would have gotten like maybe one or two new bachelors and bachelorettes that weren't actually in the game before. But I mean, that would obviously take a lot of work and time, but it would have been cool. Moped Dude says, hey, that new Harvest Moon game you're looking forward to is out next month. Ha ha ha, funny. Although I am thinking about doing a video on it. Natsumail blacklist me if I do that. Is my cat okay? He looks dead. Oh yeah, I have a bunch of stuff. Huh. Forgot about that. Robin's lost axe, we know where that is. And we need to make a copper bar. Well, that's easy. That's not what I needed. There we go. Alright, so we got a couple quests here that we need to do. I am happy that he made it so that you can change, like, if you put your coop somewhere and then you decide you don't like it there, you can move it if you go to Robin's. So that's pretty awesome. But I think what we're gonna do is head down and find Robin's axe just so that we can get that quest, like, out of my inventory. Hey, Mystic Jedi, what's up? You got the dog? I didn't get the dog. I thought you wanted to be nicer to your last dog? No. I hated the dog. The dog was super annoying. So, I decided this time I was gonna go with the cat because it doesn't make noise. The cat's more chill. The cat works better. Haha's extra. Echoey said I should hide my sandwich from you so you don't steal it, but I already ate it, so. Ha. Sucks for you. Oh, well, that was hard. Alright. Is there anything else over here to get? I guess the forage didn't come back yet. Well, there's one little sad spring onion. We can go give the axe to Robin. Mystic Jedi says, I'm so tickled you liked my tweet. Twitter is probably the easiest way to connect with me. It's just fast, and I'm really not good at keeping up with Facebook. I'm not the biggest fan of Facebook anyway, but Twitter is like so much easier to talk with people. I think if you got cats for real, they would chase the dogs. We have cats and the dogs chase them, so the dogs don't like the cats. Even though my cat is much, well, one of them is much bigger than my dogs. He's enormous. But he still runs away from the dogs. My cat's lazy in real life, too. He kind of lays around like a lion. We should buy the bigger bag. That is something we should do. Alright, what do we got? No, I want to see the quest. Quest. Not what I wanted. Quest. What the heck? There we go, jeez. I'm not catching a catfish. Get it yourself. Alright. Yes. Whoa! Awesome. Awesome sauce. Alright, and the next one's what, 10? Yeah. Okay. I think I'll save a little bit because we want to buy some strawberry seeds. Whoa, hello. Lover from a previous life. Because I think it's at the egg festival that you can buy strawberries, not the flower dance, so I need to save a little bit. Probably should have waited and spent that money on strawberries, but what are you gonna do? Mystic Jedi says, I've been playing Pokemon Go all day when I should have been getting my apartment complex's inspection tomorrow. Well, it happens to the best of us. Hey, MMO Cloud, what's up? He's not a Maine Coon, but he's really... He's just a big cat. He's not like super fat, he's just enormous. Wait, no. Here, I have your axe. There you go. Excellent. 2 out of 10 green slimes defeated. I don't know if we could do that now. Probably not. Probably run out of stamina, but we could give it a shot. Could at least get some of them. Something to do. All right. Are there any slimes in here? Probably not. So, blank name says, so at 7 p.m. on Thursday, I check if there's a new episode of Steven Universe. Instead, there was a commercial of the next Teen Titans Go episodes in which they are making it an entire joke on the original Teen Titans. I'm beyond pissed right now at Cartoon Network. Yeah, Teen Titans Go is not... like the original. I haven't really seen much of the original myself. I'm more of a Justice League person, but I've seen enough of both to know they're not very similar. And unfortunately, Justice League action looks to be the same way. Like, I saw the preview that they released of that and was like, eh. Doesn't look very good, but I'm pretty sure it's being produced by the same guy that does Teen Titans Go, so there you go. It annoys me that, like, ugh, I hate this thing, that they take these shows that are still kids' shows, but appeal to a lot of different ages, and then they almost like make them really childish and are almost kind of insulting to kids in a way. It's just kind of frustrating. Are there really no slimes in here either? Oh, wow. Well, the ladder's right there. Ugh. I was hoping for a cave carrot. Really hoping for a cave carrot. FK36 says, forgot to befriend Marnie playing Stardew myself right now. Yeah, I'll have to do that again. Ugh, the sword. Awful. So bad. At least we found some slimes. Alright. Here's another one. Back here. Alright, what do we have? Five of them now? Yeah. Haley is your closest friend? That's weird. Especially that she'd have two hearts if you're not even really talking to her. Oh wait, I'm gonna miss that level 10. I should probably try to get there. I don't have, like, I think this is the only thing I have to eat. But, yes. Eat that. I'll try to find the ladder. There we go. Alright, good. Oh, I forgot about that. You got rewards. There we go. Put my leather boots on. Plus one defense and plus one immunity, so that's good. I think we're gonna peace out. Because I don't have much energy. Is he a Garfield cat? He's yellow. He's not orange, he's like a yellow cat. MMO Cloud says, The Walking Dead just keeps getting better and better after season 3 and 4. I really wanted to watch The Walking Dead, but it was too gory. Like, I kind of almost threw up a little bit. Dies Alone says, how do I sacrifice Shane to Joja? Penny's your side girl, Echoey? Jeez. Wow. Hi, Luna the Third, what's up? Oh, we have a bunch of geodes. I should take them to the blacksmith. That's something I should do. Sacrifice Joja to make your farm better. I would. You're giving your cat a bath right now? That doesn't seem like a good idea. Smiley says, I don't know what to name my Stardew Valley character, LMAO. I don't know, chat. What do you guys think? What should Smiley's name their Stardew Valley character? Echoey says, I'm surprised gore is a problem for you. No, it's a big problem. I'm very squeamish. Level 2 mining, plus 1 pickaxe proficiency, and staircase. Jeez. I don't know what's going on with my throat. It's raining. Drakita, tomorrow we're holding the egg festival in the town square, blah blah blah, 9 to 2. I hope I don't forget about that. But I could see me forgetting about that. What do we have in the thing? Okay. Wait, I didn't put any of them in there? I should have some of them. Alright, geodes, and we have parsnip. Potato. I don't think anything else grew yet. Because they take longer. But we can put those in the community center a while. And... Alright, well, we're going to work on the quality parsnips. Not going to get this stuff for a while, probably. Same with the animal bundle. Yeah. Oh, wait. Is the fish tank open now? Okay. Someone should look up which fish I can catch in spring. Ooh, I could do this one, probably. If I go to the ocean. Alright, first, let's get some wood so that we can fix that bridge, because we never did that. So let's do that first. And then... Jeez, I forgot how... You always forget how long everything takes when you start one of these games and your tools suck. Mystic Jedi says, I'm so excited for your Sun and Moon Let's Play, but which one are you getting and which starter? I'm getting Pokemon Sun, and my husband is going to get Pokemon Moon, which is what we usually do. So, like, one of us will get one version, the other one will get the other version. And I'm kind of looking at Litten. Like, that's been pretty much my... decision, but I really need to see the final forms before I commit because I got screwed over with Fennekin and I don't want it to happen again. Delphox seriously ruined Fennekin for me. And I'm not over it. I love fire starters. I almost always choose the fire starter. And I was just really upset about it. Also, I'm really hoping that the typing is fire dark or something. Just not firefighting. We'll have to see. How much wood does it take to fix that bridge? Is it 200? I have a feeling it's 200. It's gonna be a problem. Although I might be able to make a field snack. No, I don't think I have enough. Craig Knuckle says, Rowlet is my starter decision. Rowlet looks pretty cool. But, again, I love my fire types. Mystic Jedi says, but I like Fennekin. I like Fennekin too, but Delphox really just messed up that whole evolutionary line. Because Delphox was a monster. Your backspace key is working? How did that work? Did you fix it? Squishy Pixel says, I love water starters, but I'm sure this time I also like cute Pokemon. I don't know, if Popplio has a really cool final evolution, it could happen. I'm not saying it won't. Why did I come in here? I don't know. I don't think I meant to do that. Trash picking in the rain. Saggy newspaper. Isn't that a metaphor for life? Somiley says, Larvitar's best Pokemon. I know I'm biased, but you have to understand, it's Larvitar we're talking about. Why are you standing in the rain? That's kind of depressing. Also, I didn't mean to go in here either. I FK306 says Growlithe is the best. I'm excited about the... the one new Pokemon that I can't remember what it's called, but it's like a poison ground lizard thing, I think. It just reminds me of my favorite Pokemon, and I'm excited to use it, so. Salamandit? Is that what it's actually called? I thought it was... I didn't think the name was that long. Zextra says Scyther is my boy. I always got angry trying to get Scyther in Pokemon Snap. Alright, we got a reward. Congrats on your job, Mystic Jedi. Ooh, cauliflower seeds. That's useful. How long does it take to grow? 12 days. Well, we have time. If we plant them today. Oh, really? I just got another geode out of the trash? Figures. Alright. Fine. The Sick Jedi says Lucario. Captain Quindolin actually got me a plushie of my favorite, well, not my favorite Pokemon, but it's like first evolution. I guess it's not, it's before, it's pre-evolution, I guess is what you would call it. Who throws out geodes? I know, right? Especially right there. Like, he could have just as easily had Clint open it and then put whatever was in it in the museum. Lazy. Zextra says, anytime Kita says Geode, I jump to Geode. What did I forget? Blank name. Okay. Arsnip, potato, and that's all we have. Jojamart sucks. That's true. I did forget to say it, but I think we all knew that I meant it. I was saying it really loud in my head. Mystic Jedi says, thanks, but it's not set yet. The lady asked me a few questions and I filled out an application and she said she'd review Friday and call me next week. Well, good luck. Luna the Third says, I can finally see the screen! Zextra says, Mojo Jojo Mart. Beautiful. Oh, 300 pieces of wood? Are you serious? That's garbage. Was it always 300? I thought it was 200. I call shenanigans. Blank Name says, my most powerful Pokemon is my Gardevoir. It has Moonblast, Psychic, Magical Leaf, and Future Sight. I have a shiny, Gallade. Which I'm pretty happy about because he's blue. I really should do more shiny hunting streams. I haven't done one of those in a while. It never rains in Calico Desert. That's where my friend Sandy lives. Uh-huh. That sounds like you're trying to make a joke. You know Sandy? She lives in the desert. It's funny, right? Luna the Third says, I've never played a Pokemon game, so sad. That is sad. They're quite fun. They are quite fun. Uh-oh. I gotta watch that. But I need to plant my cauliflower. You can only use your hoe so much before you pass out. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Goodness. It's happening again. Starting the rainbow. Taste the rainbow. Okay. How do I want to... I should probably just... Probably gonna make... I know I'm gonna use them anyway, so I might as well just, like, start making them. I'll just have to cut down all that wood again. To fix the bridge. But oh well. Here we go! These are really subtle, though. I might need to make them more obviously different. You know what I mean? They're like, there's not much difference between them. Anyway. We'll do anything fish or ocean related in here, I think. Let's see. And then maybe we'll just do mining stuff. Oh, whoops, I'm out of space already, jeez. Alright. We'll do mining stuff in here, like materials and all that stuff. And... Yep. Trying to figure out a good organizational system. You're fish related. You're actual fish, so you're fish related. You can go in here. Okay. I guess I'll just leave for right now crops and foraging stuff in there. Yes. Sound good? Cyan goes between seafoam green and light blue, or is it lake foam green? What are you, a Crayola box? Oh, we got a decent amount of copper, at least. Should probably consider upgrading the watering can at the end of the month. That would probably be a good idea. Thinking about it. I'll have to try to remember that. I just thought I heard something. Could be wrong. Sounded like someone was yelling. Everything else will just have to go in there. Alright. We have no energy. So. Well, I guess I could go and look and see if we have any foraging stuff around the farm before we go to bed. Did chat in the video freeze? Oh, did it? Dang it. There. Hopefully it's fixed. The chests are magical coolers. Oh no, the fish don't go bad.
What?
Yeah, the chat should be fixed now.
What are you looking for?
Well, I know where all the wires are, so if you decide that you need help, just ask. Yes, but see, now the hoarding can be done in rainbow colors. So it's more fun. Level 2 foraging survival burger. Your video is black? I don't know why that is. Is the wilderness farm worth it? I mean, I like the layout. The fishing one was cool, but it wouldn't really be practical, at least for me. Because there's not a lot of room for actual farming on that one. Like, it's all an island, sort of. And it'd be really annoying, I think, to navigate. Ugh, out of water. Taste the rainbow, exactly. Key to the hoarder now in color. I'm really excited about that because it would be really annoying to try to remember what was in your different chests. And hopefully this will help. I don't know, because like I said, those colors are really close, so I might just have to be like, you know, purple, blue, green, instead of actually having it be the gradient. Alright, what do we have here? Robin, shut up. I don't have time or money to deal with you right now. Kinda sucks that I'd have no money. Considering that today is the festival where we could buy stuff that I want. But what are you gonna do? FK306 says, I enjoy the hilltop farm. Got my own tiny section to mine ore. That's pretty cool. Zextra says, have you watched Alchus Breach? I don't know if that's how you say it. Play Fallout. He picks up everything. Dude, that would be me. That's why I've never done a Fallout Let's Play. Plus, I've never really... I only played a little bit of Fallout 4, but that would be me. I would pick up everything. Will you see me in Bioshock? I have to hack everything. I have to pick up everything. I have to look at everything. It just annoys me if I don't. So. I only need $5 more. I only need $5 more to get another thing of strawberry seeds. Somebody loan me $5. Will you loan me $5? Will you loan me $5? Leah, will you loan me $5? No, I'm trying to increase my friendship with people. Go away, Lewis. Isn't that your name? Lewis?
What's everybody so happy about?
Luna the Third says, I love Fallout. I think I would really like it. Oh, hey, Dreamcatcher Wolf. Sent here by Cat for the win. Was she streaming? I didn't know that she was streaming if she was. But welcome. We're just playing some Stardew Valley. We do chill streams every Wednesday, so we just kind of hang out and chat. Very relaxed. But everybody's pretty welcoming, so... Uh-oh, Allie snuck in.
Allie, what are you doing? Is she annoying? Well, just, you can leave her in here. She'll probably just lay down. Allie, just lay down.
Look at me, I'm a bunny. Alright. Find Shane and kick him. You don't like Shane very much, do you? Strawberry seeds at 1K? What? They're only 100. Or did you think they were 1K? Thankfully they're not, because I would not be able to afford it. Do you have any other LucasArts games? I've heard of the Day of the Tentacle. I actually found Day of the Tentacle at a thrift store. So I do have it. Unfortunately, it doesn't have the original case, which bothers me to no end. But I did manage to pick it up for like $1, I think it was. At a thrift store, which was pretty cool. That's one I never played. I'm trying to think if I played any, like, besides the Humongous Entertainment games, I didn't really play any major ones that you guys would know of. Like, I didn't really play Secret of Monkey Island, or I didn't really have LucasArts games as a kid. I used to watch my grandfather play Myst all the time, though, which I really liked. I don't think I would have played it myself as a kid, because it kind of freaked me out a little bit, to be honest. But other than, like, the Humongous Entertainment games, the other games I played were, like, Barbie. I did love point-and-click games, though. Like, I had Disney ones, I had Barbie ones. I did do a video of me playing Barbie Magic Hair Styler. Weirdly, it has, like... I think 1,000 views or something, and I'm like, that is very surprising. No, 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 no! I was so close! So close. Blank name says Shane's an asshole, he doesn't have any worth. Wow. Savage. It's Abigail, we know. Oh my gosh, wait, how did I win? I didn't even get any. How did I win? John Monroe says, hi everyone, X-Men theme stops. Hey, John Monroe, what's up? Zextra says, Barbie Horse Detective is the best game ever. Dude, that's how I found Luka Jin, watching her Barbie Horse Adventure Let's Plays. It was so beautiful. It's really funny. I do want to play Barbie Detective at some point, because quality right there. It actually wasn't a bad game, like, for, you know, being a kid's game and being aimed at girls, because a lot of times we got really crappy games aimed at us. Oh, look at my little straw hat. You guys like my straw hat? Just like my straw hat? Meow. All right. I think you glitched the system. Yeah, because I thought she got like 11 or something, didn't she? Or at least 10. I don't know how I won that. I'm very confused. Alright, so I'm actually going to learn a recipe. I learned how to make coleslaw. Aren't you guys proud of me? I always forgot to watch TV last time. Ooh, we got cauliflower. We got cauliflower. A little bit, not much. Would you guys be, I just reminded myself of something that Moped Dude said earlier. Would you guys be interested in seeing a video on the new Harvest Moon game, like the Natsume one? Because that's coming out early November, and I thought, you know what? We could do a first impressions of that. I'm not expecting much, but we can still do it. That's something you guys would be interested in seeing. I feel like I need to do more one shots, because Like, sometimes I don't know if I want to do a full Let's Play of a certain game. I'm not sure how it's going to go. So I feel like if I did a first impressions, then it would kind of give you guys an idea of the game, and it would give me an idea of the game, and then I could kind of go from there and be like, okay, I think, you know, I'd want to do a full Let's Play of this, or, you know, I'd rather do something else. But that's just something I've been thinking about. No, it said Queen of Sauce, blank name. It didn't say Lady of Sauce. Rip Harvest Moon Back to Nature. Why don't they do some kind of remake of that? Like, good grief, I would love it. No, Natsume sucks. I'm not saying it would be positive. I'm just saying it would be a first impressions video. Which new game? I don't even know what it's called. Honestly. I don't even remember what it's called. Did I? Oh my gosh, I didn't even water anything. Wow. I got excited about the cauliflower and I didn't water anything. Figures. Skytree Village? Yeah, I think that's what it's called. I saw the trailer for it, and I was unimpressed would be an understatement. I just don't think that it looks very good. But it'd probably be like the Yo-Kai Watch situation. I would do the video and then not like the game, and then people would be upset because I didn't like the game and give me a thumbs down because they disagreed with my not liking the game. Which is just kind of funny to me because I don't know. It seems like a weird reason to dislike a video just because you disagree. Instead of being like, oh, this actual video is bad, as opposed to the content. But no, Skytree Village is coming out in November. Smiley says, when I was doing culinary, my instructor cut his finger during the first demonstration. Wow. It's like, can I get a refund for this class? Luna the Third says, you like what you like. Everyone's different. That's true. I had certain expectations of Yo-Kai Watch, and I just felt like it was a watered-down Pokemon. I just didn't like the battling system. I just didn't like it. I mean, and I thought I was pretty fair. I wasn't nasty about it. I mean, I said I can see why some people would enjoy this game. It's just not for me. But, you know, that's how it goes. I don't think I'll be that nice with Harvest Moon, to be honest. I don't know if I'll be that diplomatic about it. You're getting Pokemon Sun in November? I would get that. And not the new Harvest Moon game. It's probably gonna be one of those situations where I get it, review it, and then trade it back in. Which I never trade in games because it's almost never worth it. But if I did it right away, it probably would be. Okay, what am I doing? I'm just walking around like a moron. Right, we need to get wow, we do not have very much wood because I had to make 500 chests. You know what happens? A blank name says, I hate the battling system of Yo-Kai Watch. Yeah, I just, wasn't my thing. Was not my thing. I was also thinking of there's that new Sonic Boom game just come out. Just came out, I think it was the end of September. So I thought that might be funny. To just take a look at that. I mean, funny in a horrifying sort of way. But I don't know. I feel like I need some more variety on the channel. And, I just heard my husband in the other room go, "Huh," when I was talking about Sonic Boom. But yeah, I feel like I need some more variety on the channel. Like, you know, something... spice things up a little bit. So I thought maybe doing some one-shots and possibly some first looks and stuff might go away. Might do that for me. Because I've just been doing a lot of Let's Plays and some of them have been really long. Like Story of Seasons, so I kind of wouldn't mind doing some shorter projects. Try some different things. It'll have to wait until after Halloween. Because as soon as Bioshock is over, the Halloween LP is going to take the Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Sunday slot. Just up until Halloween. Like Halloween is like the last episode. And then we'll have to see. 26 people watching the stream. Hello, 26 people. Do you like my hat? Twilight Observer says my physical science teacher lit the floor of his classroom. Wow. Luna the Third says, I'd watch you play a Pokemon game. You are in luck, my friend. Because I'm playing Pokemon Sun. Like, I'm gonna do full Let's Play. And that'll be as soon as the game comes out. So. Not too far away. Actually. Let's see. That's not what I wanted to look at. Alright. So, what can we do here? Alright, so we did that. Exotic forage. No, we can't do that. That's also gonna have to wait. Fish tank. See, like, we don't have much energy. Right, blacksmith's bundle. Right, okay. I want to try to knock some of these bundles out earlier because when I was first playing, it kind of took me a while to do that. And I don't want it to take forever in this one. Luna the Third says GTA 5 is expensive, like 60 bucks. How is it still 60 bucks? I thought it went down to like 40. Kita make 12-year-old cry. What did I do? I didn't do anything. You can't prove it. Oh, you gotta go clean? Alright, well, see you later. Thanks for stopping by, Mystic Jedi. How many episodes of Bioshock are left? What episode went up to today? 20. I think 24 went up today, so there's 28 episodes total. So it should be done. Well, there's. Alright, so there's 28 episodes, and I'm doing a montage. So it'll be done next Friday. No, next Sunday. I think the actual series will be done on Friday, and then the montage will be on Sunday. Still pursuing Elliot? No, I'm not. He was just there, so I figured I would talk to him. That's all it was. Don't read into it. Oh, that's what it is on Steam? That's weird. It just seems like it would have come down. I'm probably thinking of the console version, but still. Who am I going for in this game? I really don't know. I don't know yet. Elliot was always my favorite. I didn't really have, like, a second place. So, we'll have to see. I gotta watch that, man. Go after Super Saiyan? I'm thinking about it. Most of them don't really appeal to me, to be honest. Like, Harvey is super old and kind of creepy. And, oh, I was gonna try to go up and get the treasure chest. And Sebastian is an edgelord. And Alex is a douchebag. So. Smiley says, I'm going for Shane if it wasn't obvious. Get the Sam booty. Super Cheeky Monkey says, oh, no more Bioshock and Story of Seasons. So sad. At least Pokemon Sun will replace it. Yeah, I gotta find something that goes between Pokemon Sun and Bioshock. Or, I mean, the Halloween Let's Play. I was thinking about one game. I'm not sure now. I'm, like, second-guessing myself. But maybe I'll still do it. I don't know. Oh, good night, Squishy Pixels. Thanks for hanging out for a little bit. I think... I don't know. Maybe I'll still do it. Although, people have been asking about Bioshock 2. And I think I want to do that because it would be... Ooh. I need to go back to my house. Oh no, I'm sluggish, because I'm almost dead. That's not good. Rune Factory 4 could be one of them in between. Rune Factory 4 would not take me 2 weeks to complete, though. That would be too much. Because Pokemon Sun and Moon is already going to take a while to beat. Like, usually I put in, like, 80 hours, at least, just playing the main story. And then if I do anything extra, it would take longer. So I don't think Rune Factory 4 is gonna be going in between them. The walking simulation? Yeah, it's super fun, isn't it? And plus, I also have The Sims, and I have Animal Crossing. I really don't want to do three games that are that similar at one time, because I would get bored. Because, I mean, if you think about it, I have Sims, which is simulation, Animal Crossing, which is simulation, and then also, I mean, Stardew Valley is simulation, so that's, like, already three Sims that I'm doing. So that would be way too much. Why not marry yourself? Marry Sephiroth? Never played Final Fantasy. Although, I do know Sephiroth because of Kingdom Hearts. When is HD Batman Arkham game coming out? It is coming out October 18th. So, this coming Tuesday? I have it written down in my planner. But yeah. I would like to play that game, but I don't know. Certain game types don't go very well on the channel. for full Let's Plays. Granny Evelyn, thank you, Granny Evelyn, for that awesome insight to life. I don't even know what I have in here. Wait. Okay. So we have some of these, and we have some of these. Guess I'll keep that. Probably just sell those. Keep that cauliflower. And could probably put some of this stuff in the community center. Okay. I don't know if we need these fish or not. Either way. The only problem with the, what are these called? Mixed seeds is that a lot of times it ends up being foraging stuff, which I don't think you get as much money for. I don't think so, at least. How about Cooking Mama? Cooking Mama's actually kind of fun. And the voiceover makes me laugh. Luna the Third says, oh yeah, I saw the Sims Let's Play on your channel. Yep, just started, so I don't know how long that's gonna be. I mean, with the Sims, you can always start another series with a different family, so I don't know. Plus, the Apartments expansion is gonna come out, so I don't know. Depending on how it goes, we might play that for a while. You could play Outlast for Halloween. I could, but Outlast has been done to death. I feel like if I did that, it would be a stream, and I would make Quindolin play it. She's much more entertaining with scary games. I don't really scream or anything. Like, I'm just kind of like, I gasp, or I'm like, oh. Or I'm just not fazed at all, and just like, oh, hey. Most of the time. So, I don't think it would really be that fun for you guys to watch me play that. SpongeBob's getting canceled? What? I didn't hear that. You pre-ordered City Living? That's cool. Oh, missed the fish tank. Camp Quindolin says she's not like me. Yeah, Camp Quindolin's the funny one to watch when playing a scary game. Did I really not get any fish that are worth anything? Because that's garbage. And I'm upset about it. Very upset right now. Play a Tomb Raider game? Again, the thing is, like, it's a time situation because the Halloween LP is going to be done on Halloween. And then I have, like, I don't know, 3 weeks, a little less, before Pokemon would start. So, I kind of have to figure out what I can do in that amount of time. And BioShock, for example, took me 28 episodes. So, Lucius023, thank you for the follow. Is that a Harry Potter reference, perchance? How about Heavy Rain? Oh, Heavy Rain, such a good game. I do want to play that. I'd have to look up and see how long it takes to beat it, though, because this is essentially something that I would have to do in, like, 12 episodes. And I don't want to make them really long. Long episodes are such a drag to edit. So, I don't know. I just don't know. I mean, unless I doubled up, which I have thought about doing. Like, doing two episodes instead of one on those days, or just kind of like doing a lot of episodes like I did with Bioshock for a while, just to like kind of make the timing work out. I don't know how that's gonna work. You should play Endless Ocean. I don't have that, I don't think. Pretty sure I don't. We do have a good... We have a lot of games. But we don't have... I don't think we have that one. Alright, I need to go to the... Okay, I don't need to go to the store because I have no money, so... Scratch that. However, we could still chop down some wood at least. Oh, your name is... Okay, can you sound that out for me? I don't want to say it wrong. I'm probably going to mispronounce it. But you're Brazilian? That's awesome. Hey, PP. I hope you're having a good day, too. Go mug Shane for money. I feel like if we were going to mug anyone, it should be the JoJo Mart. Just, like, rob the entire store. And if Shane gets in the way, then, you know. Happens. What the heck am I stuck on? Are you getting the Skyrim remaster for consoles? I've never played Skyrim. Mostly because I would be afraid that I'd get sucked into it. Which is part of the reason why I stopped playing Fallout. Because... I was playing Fallout 4 on my own, and when I first started playing it, I played it for hours, and I was like, oh my god. I need to work. It's not good. Super Cheeky Monkey says, who purchased Harvest Moon The Lost Valley and played it for 5 minutes before throwing it out the window? That's probably what I would have done, but I didn't purchase it at all. So, problem solved. You guys realize Sam works at JoJo Mart too? Lol. PP says, Fallout, I saw a custom Fallout PC case. That's cool. Ah, 150. We need 300 for that? It's garbage. Also, it's only 2 o'clock, and I've, like, no energy. And I guess I can make field snacks. And I can eat this field snack. Maybe I'll do that. Rue, when did you come in here? Rue, what are you doing, buddy? What are you doing, buddy? Allie left and was replaced with Rue. Unless she went under the cover. Sometimes she does that. Alright. Eat this. Eat the field snack. Look at them pretty butterflies. Wow, that gave me like no energy. It's like not even worth it. Richard Dang says, I feel like Story of Seasons is replacing Harvest Moon. Well, Story of Seasons technically is Harvest Moon. Like, it started out... Like, the original Harvest Moon started out in Japan as this one name that I can't pronounce. And when it was localized over here, they called it Harvest Moon. Like, and then what happened was there was, like, a split. So... now Marvelous has Story of Seasons, because they couldn't use Harvest Moon because Natsume owns the name Harvest Moon. So technically Story of Seasons actually is the original Harvest Moon. And then Natsume is like making their own. So it's very complicated and stupid. There are 27 people on right now instead of the usual 15. Yeah, it's probably because I'm playing Stardew Valley. People are excited to watch again. Stardew Valley rated M for mature. Oh my gosh, guys. Like, could you imagine me just going around with an axe hitting things in the face? My cat? No, my dog, actually. We don't let the cats downstairs because I am very allergic and will die. So, I mean, not actually, but like, my throat kind of gets itchy and I have trouble. Like, I sneeze a lot and stuff. Salmonberry? No, my dog, actually, she's small. She's like, I think she's 11 pounds or 10 pounds, and she's really skinny. And she's tiny, so she like burrows under the covers and then you sit on her because you don't realize she's there. Super Cheeky Monkey says, my cousin is really bad at playing games. I find it painful to watch her attempting to play any game. Oh my gosh, I know. Cousins, right? They suck at video games. I don't even know if Captain Quinlan's paying attention at this point. We're still trying to figure out if we're gonna stream when she's down. So keep a lookout. I'll try to do a video announcing it if we do. But I don't know what we would play. Just Because I'm Cool says, hey boys, I'm back and here tonight. Yes. As in hitting things, you mean Shane? What has Shane done to you? Shane has wronged you. Captain Quinlan says, rude. So she was here the whole time. She was just waiting for me to say something bad about her. I see her game. The shade. Craig Nook says, I would fish your butt off once those crops are done. It's what I did and already in fall. I have 28 quality sprinklers refreshing cranberries for me and we'll be abusing some strawberries and cauliflower. Oh, that's a good idea. I'm just trying to fix the bridge. Like, that's all I was really trying to do. But yeah, we should probably focus on fishing. That would be a good way to get some cash. Hey, kitty. You don't look like you're dying anymore. Salmonberry. Go in there. Alright. Oh, no, it didn't come out as rude, Cracky Nook. I just didn't... I mean, I saw it, but I didn't see it, if you know what I mean. I was reading other things, and then I had to, like, scroll up to it. Alright. Is there anything over here to forage? My farm looks like garbage. Hate that. Oh, there's some more salmon berries. I'm also sad that I don't have my perk anymore where I get like extra forage items. Luna the Third says, I feel like everyone is so old here. I don't... Why would you feel that way? Just Because I'm Cool says, I'm almost married to Sebastian. There you go. Super Cheeky Monkey says, force her to play Outlast or Until Dawn. That would be so funny. I actually was with her when she was playing Until Dawn, which is pretty funny. Echoey says, my first experience with the Walking Dead game was watching my sister play it with headphones in. I'm surprised how accurately I imagined the voices. Walking Dead is, like, brutal. Emotionally. The streets need to be cleared and cleansed of Shane. Oh my gosh. I think Dies Alone is hoping that Shane dies alone. Okay, Pierre, stop advertising. Okay, does this mean that the crows got my crops? Is that what that means? Because, like, do I need to make another scarecrow? Is that what's happening here? I think that might be what's happening. You're 13? I'm pretty sure Mystic Jedi is pretty young, too. I mean, he's not here right now. He had to leave, but there's a couple people that aren't. And none of us are old. Rude. Granny stream. Pretty much, though. Oh, there's some cinnamon berries. Put that right in there. And I kind of want to finish this just to get it done. So I want to save this, though. I don't want to use that right now. I guess we'll just go and wing it, hopefully. What? Ugh. Mixed seeds, get in there. Alright. We'll go and hopefully we can get to the, get 5 more slimes killed. I really just want to get that quest out of my quest log so it's not just sitting there. All you whippersnappers. Cracky Knuckles says, I just turned 29 yesterday, so I'm old. Oh, happy birthday, though. It's all about how old you feel. I mean, that's not going to hold up in a court of law, but you know what I mean. Lena the Third says, I didn't mean old like that. I'm just kidding. Anyway, all you whippersnappers. Zextra says, mentally I'm 6 or 80. That's pretty much me. It's one or the other. It doesn't really, there's not an in-between. Jeez, Smileys. Make it dark. Alright, let's go murder some slimes. Oh, is this where those gross bug things start happening? I hate the noise. I really don't like the buzzing noise that they make. It really bothers me. Okay, nothing is in here. A slime genocide. Pretty much. Adulting makes you old. Exactly, so don't. You should just shirk all your responsibilities. Lesson of the day. Don't be responsible. Murder, 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 murder. Murder, 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 murder. Alright, he's murdered. Oh no! I hate those things. I hate you so much. Come on. Ew. Grossest noises ever. I hate you so much. Ruining my life. Oh good, another slime. Excellent. Get out of here! Get out of here! Get out of here. You suck. I want my awesome sword back. I maintain that this game should have, like, New Game Plus. Slime Rancher. It is kind of like Slime Rancher. In that sense. Oh, look at this. This area is infested, really? Do we really have to do that right now? Like, I was just trying to get to level 15. I don't feel like dealing with this crap. Alright. So now we can head into the Adventurer's Guild, although I don't think it opens till 2? You stubbed your toe? That sucks. Well, I hope you're okay. Alright, come on. I just want into your secret club. I just want to be a part of your secret club. Zextro says, I wish I could be in a cartoon. Echoey put you in a cartoon. I don't know what you're complaining about. You're in the cartoon where you stole my sandwich. Or did you forget? Alright. Not bad for a piece of carved wood. Alright, well, wow, that was exciting. Not really. Okay, but we got that done, so we can focus on fishing. Which I think would be a good idea. Let's find a nice spot, work on our fishing. At least there's the Pokemon Sun and Moon demo to look forward to, that's true. Wow. Didn't even put up a fight. Corp. I never watched Kids Next Door. That was one I never saw. Chub. Smiley says, I just look ugly and damn proud of it too. I'm ugly and I'm proud. Look what you did, Zextro. Now Echoey's upset. Don't upset the artist. She'll draw a picture of you getting eaten by a big daddy. Hey, Umbreon's RS, what's up? You were grocery shopping. That sounds fun. Actually, no, I hate grocery shopping. With a passion. I hate most shopping that involves me leaving the couch. How dare you not watch Kids Next Door? I don't think I had... Was that Cartoon Network? I feel like at that point we didn't have Cartoon Network because we kind of went back and forth. Like, at one point we had Nickelodeon, then we had Cartoon Network for like a little bit, and then we had Nickelodeon. But that was just one that I never... I don't know, I just never watched. It's not like I watched and I hated it. I just never really saw it. The same with Recess, which a lot of kids watched, I guess. Smiley says, if I ever take you shopping, I'll let you ride the cart. Thank you. How did you know? That's... I always ride in the cart. It was Cartoon Network? I thought so. The shows that I watched on Cartoon Network were Johnny Bravo, Dexter's Lab. Ooh, I got an achievement. Ed and Eddy. Powerpuff Girls. Cow and Chicken. Sometimes. That one wasn't as good, if I would rate them. That one wasn't quite as good as some of the others. Although I did like it. I think those are the main ones that I watched on Cartoon Network. I watched a lot of Nickelodeon shows because we had that network. Like our cable package, we had it. So I'd watch, like, Angry Beavers, Hey Arnold, SpongeBob, obviously, once it came out. Fairly Odd Parents. Never really liked Jimmy Neutron. Honestly, never really my thing. I used to really like the game shows that they had on Nickelodeon, like Guts and Legends of the Hidden Temple. So good. Figure It Out. I watched Double Dare sometimes. Although, again, that one wasn't, like, my favorite. Adventure Time died. Yeah, they're canceling Adventure Time, which is really sad. I like Adventure Time. Hey, guys. Hello to all the new people. Just joined. Just fishing. We are on a new file. Some of you weren't here in the last stream, so I feel like I should say that. We started a new file. We have a new farm now, so we're kind of starting over. I'm going to be marrying someone different. Probably Sam, but I'm not sure. Cam Quinlan says, Legends of the Hidden Temple. I think they're making a movie of it, though. Or, like, a remake. They're doing something with it. I saw that on Twitter. There's a rumor that they're trying to revive Danny Phantom. Yeah, I never got into Danny Phantom. Or My Life as a Teenage Robot. Never got into that either. Oh, I also watched The Rugrats. That was, like, the other thing that I couldn't think of. I loved The Rugrats growing up. Can you just stop being a jerk face for 5 seconds? Fish. If my fishing skill doesn't go up, I'm going to drain all the water out of the lake. Oh, yeah, there's tons of new people. Well, not like new people who have never been to a stream, but just new people for this evening. So hello, everybody who just joined. Do you like my hat? Echoey says, I just need to clarify, I can make you a masochist sandwich. Does the update only work on new accounts? No, the update itself will work on everything. It's just if you want a new farm, you have to start a new file because you choose your farm layout at the very beginning of the game. So if you want any of the new farm layouts, like I have the forest farm, there's also a fishing farm, there's one for mining, there's one for combat. Am I missing one? I don't think so. I think I got all of them. But if you want one of the new farm layouts, then you have to start over. But everything else should be fine. I did see that Lionsgate is making a Power Rangers movie. Cracky Knuckles says, the remake of Powerpuff Girls has me sad for the possible remake of Samurai Jack. I don't think Samurai Jack is getting a remake. I thought they were just finishing the story arc. I didn't think it was actually getting like a full-fledged remake. I could be wrong. But yeah, the Powerpuff Girls remake makes me very sad as well. Rugrats Grown Up. I kind of liked Rugrats Grown Up a little bit. Wasn't amazing, but I still watched it. Blank Name says, I hate the new Powerpuff Girls. I heard that it's not great. Which really makes me sad because I loved that show as a kid. They're just finishing the show? That's what I thought. I love how everyone is like really, really salty about the Powerpuff Girls. I also grew up watching Powerpuff Girls, Super Cheeky Monkey. I haven't watched it either, but I've seen clips from it, and I'm not a fan. Smiley's, I remember As Told by Ginger. I liked that show too. I remember being like super floored because the voice actress for Ginger was like, it's a weird reference, but I really liked the Tony Hawk games as a kid. And in Tony Hawk Underground, there was actually a story, and you could do a custom character and everything, so I made a custom character, and then after I did that, her voice actor was the same woman who voiced Ginger in As Told by Ginger, and I just was, like, so amazed by that as a kid. So. It's so nice to be good at fishing in this game now. When I started, I was really not good at fishing. Alright. No. Okay. So we'll put one of those.
Caught you a delicious bass.
One of those. I think some of these go in the... community center. But I don't remember which ones. So we'll just have to... Oh wait, no, I can just check, duh. I forget that I can just check. Sunfish, catfish. None of those, of course. None of those. Okay, so the bullhead and the carp both go in there. Really? The chub doesn't go anywhere? Poor chub. Poor chub. There, we'll keep the largemouth bass, I guess. No. Swap it out. We'll take those to the community center tomorrow. Dreamcatcher Wolf says, "Ed's told by Ginger and Wild Thornberries." I watch the Wild Thornberries from time to time. FK306 says, someone once... Oh. You're singing the song to As Told by Ginger. I recall that. Why are you guys all singing the song? I know you're singing the song in real life. Chub goes in friendship bundle. Aha. I don't think I have that unlocked yet, though. You played the Outlast 2 demo? How was it? Was it good? Queen of Sauce rerun. Lame. I never remember. Okay, so we can get hats now. Probably because I got that fishing achievement. No, don't eat the daffodil. Why would you do that? That's gross. That's a lot of forage. Wow. Okay. We'll keep those, and we'll keep a green bean, and we can probably sell the rest of these. Well, I might want to keep the leeks just because they give a decent amount of energy, but I can sell these guys. Probably sell some of these too. Yes, we'll do that. Aren't daffodils actually poisonous in real life? I don't know, I've never tried to eat one. I wouldn't recommend it. Probably not a good idea. We're gonna have to go get parsnip seeds. Oh wait, we can't because they're closed, aren't they? Well, shnikes. That sucks. We can fix the bridge though. We'll do that. We'll fix the bridge. We'll put the fish in the community center. And then maybe we'll do some more fishing at the ocean. Oh. What about Shrek? Oh no. We're singing the Shrek song now? Why? Why do you do this? I'm so confused. Although, you guys talking about Shrek reminds me, did any of you watch Monster Factory where they played Spore? It's very funny. If you haven't watched Monster Factory, it is adult. Like, the humor is definitely not safe for work. Oh, who's... Cat for the Win is now hosting! Thanks, Cat! Garrus danced for you in a provocative manner. I don't know if Kat's actually here, but if she is, thank you for the host. You guys should definitely check out her channel if you haven't. She's pretty amazing. She's my YouTube buddy. Sturgeon. I don't remember how to get that. Anyway, I don't think I have the friendship bundle yet, because I think that's here, isn't it? I think I have to, like, finish some other ones before I get that, so... Chub Chub's gonna have to wait. 30 people watching the stream. Wow, we haven't had that many in a while. It's all because of Stardew Valley, man. Capcona says, take it to the bank, boys. Seriously, though, like, Monster Factory is really funny. It's definitely something that Quindolin and I would do. Just make horrible, horrible creations in video games. You remember renting N64 games from Hollywood Video or Blockbuster? We actually had a Hollywood Video really close to us, but we didn't go there that much. I thought it was Hollywood Video. It might have been something else. Something like that. Equi says, I would make a YouTube buddy, or buddy in general, but that would mean commitment. You're like a YouTube buddy too, Equi. You did a ton of awesome stuff for the channel. Amazing artwork. I'm constantly getting compliments on it. I'm like, thanks, I did not do it. I did nothing. Hagley says, aw. It's true. Echoey's buddy to all. See, there you go. You're everyone's friend. Your family had a weekly tradition of renting movies from Blockbuster? That's cool. Kind of sad that that's like, that whole experience is gone. I remember renting games with my dad whenever I would go visit him. We would go to Blockbuster and we'd look around, and then usually he would pick a game and then I would pick a game and then we'd play them. You're destroying wildlife, don't take coral. It's too late. You never watched Monster Factory? It's really funny. It's on Polygon's YouTube channel. I think one of my favorite episodes of that is the Saints Row one. That one's really good. The WWE one is really good. That one's pretty funny. Is the cult still active? I don't know. I'm not the leader of that channel or that Twitter account. Cam Quinlan says, I have fond memories of my dad stealing games and movies from Blockbuster. Dude, I think he like went dumpster diving or something, because I have a very vivid memory of him giving me N64 games that had like straight up holes in them. Cracky Knuckle says, I would sometimes rent a PlayStation 1 from the place and rented a few games for the PS1. That's cool. I'll see you later just because I'm cool. Thanks for hanging out. You need a blood sacrifice for me? Oh my gosh. See, we need a name. Like, I need something to call you guys. Kat calls her viewers winners, which I think is really cool. But I'm not calling you cultists. I don't think it would be a good idea to open up a new Let's Play and say, hey, cultists. You know? I don't think it would be very opening, like, very welcoming to new people. Also, I don't want to be arrested. So that kind of plays into it as well. So you need to think of a more welcoming, friendly thing to call yourselves. Wow, a broken CD. Exactly what I wanted. Exactly what I expected to find when I would go fishing. Losers. Hey, losers. That's uplifting. Yeah, Kat calls her people winners. I call mine losers. That'd be super nice. Nashers? That sounds like if you went to a fast food restaurant and they didn't call French fries French fries. You call them Nashers. What about Nashists? It's like fascists. The Kita Tots. Like Scott's Tots from The Office. Sassy people. That would work. Hey, sassy people. Come join the sassy people. We are mere echoes of your greatness. Well, that's why you're called echoey, isn't it? Sass bags. The baboos. Well, these are all great names if you ever start like a basketball team. It does make you sound like toddlers. It really does, though. When someone comments on your video, but you don't know why they commented what they commented. Someone just commented on one of my videos and said, dude, what the actual fuck? And I really have no idea what this person is referring to, so I don't know how to respond. Like, I'm very confused. Kita Cats. That's kind of catchy. Servants. Just call you servants. Peasants. People with classes best because it's my idea. That's kind of a mouthful, though, to open up a video and be like, hey, people with class. Kit Cats. I could call you Kit Cats. Kit Kats is like one of my favorite candy. And I'm not a huge chocolate person. Or candy person. Although I love Sour Patch Kids. Talk like Mad Dog from Fallout. Hello, children. See, that just makes me sound creepy. That makes me sound like I live in a van. Minions. I think people are triggered from minions. Copyright strikes. I could call you copyright strikes. Super Cheeky Monkey says, how about responding with what the actual fuck do you mean? Oh, okay. Creepy, creepy. Get away from me. Danger. Stranger danger. Call you farmers. Little poofs. Sassafrassers. Catters with an H. I kind of figured you were joking. But I feel like that would trigger so many people. I don't even know what that says, Twilight Observer. Honestly. Chatters. Oh! Glitter critters. I'll call you my glitter critter. John Monroe. The idea is not to scare new people away from the channel. Would Blackie sound wrong? I think it would. I think some people might find that offensive. Wonder Kits. Fabulites. These are all great. Alright, this fish is annoying me. If I have to actually pay attention to the fishing, I'm annoyed. Zextra says, my job is to scare people away. Kita sparklers. See, like, think about it as in, what would you want to have on a t-shirt? Would you really want your t-shirt to say glitter critter? Glitter fritter. Smiley says, why don't you just call us your brother and sisters and alternate life forms? That still sounds cultish, though. I really just want this treasure. No! It's not gonna happen. No! I got greedy. Panty raiders. Again, I... The goal is that if we would ever make t-shirts, you'd be able to wear them to school without having, you know, to explain to your teacher what panty raider means. You guys are distracting me from fishing. The superstars. You would want your t-shirt to say Mayor Lewis's pants? Or to just have them on it? Groping emotional zombies. See, that's kind of a mouthful. I wouldn't want to call you guys zombies anyway because this one beauty YouTuber, Mikey, who I like, calls her people zombies. Dreamcatcher Wolf, thank you for the follow. Enjoy Amethyst's butt. Echoey says, I like Kit Kats, but copyright. Well, I could probably call you that. I don't know. I don't think that they would, like, come after me for using the word. But if I ever wanted to like, do any sort of merchandise with it, it would be kind of hard. The shirt needs to say, excuse my language. That would be good. Artix Nails says we're bad at inviting new people to the cult. You guys are extremely bad at that. I'm gonna be real with you. Key to cats instead of Kit Kats. Ghosts and ghouls? That's like Ghouls and Ghosts, the game, just backwards. Be relevant to the mainstream media, call us your clowns. This whole thing is a mess. That sums it up, Twilight Observer. It really does sum it up. Capcornlet says, I'm in a poopy mood, okay? Oh, a spoopy mood. I think you're in a poopy mood. Personally. I had to, Zextra. I had to. I didn't have a choice. To be honest, I loved the intro. That one from like a long time ago. I don't even know what that audio file was taken from, because I remember when I made that, I took that audio from some video, but I don't even remember what it was from. Call you creepers? Again, I don't think that's really... I'm not sure that's the kind of environment we're trying to create here. That sounds like a convention for, creepers. Don't think it would be a good idea to advertise ourselves as creepers. No, back here. Okay, we already have, I guess I'll put another one in there just to have it. Okay. We have an anchovy. Great. I'm not sure if any of them are in the thing. The bundle. Fish tank. What is in the ocean? Sardine, tuna, red snapper, and tilapia. Well, we have a sardine. At least. Put that in there. Death Eaters? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that has some copyright, and my behind would be in trouble if I tried to call you guys my Death Eaters. Good idea, though. But considering Harry Potter is copywritten to hell, I feel like I would have a lawsuit very quickly. Level 3 foraging. Awesome. Did we even do much foraging? The Mr. Cleaners. I just call you Voldemort. My little Voldemorts. Oh, it came from the episode where Ida dies? Aha, that would make sense. I had a feeling it came from Story of Seasons, but there's so many episodes. I can't remember stupid things I said. Like, a year ago. I don't have that ability. So, when new people come onto the channel and they're like, oh, hey, when you said this, I'm like, what? When did I say that? What stupid thing came out of my mouth that I don't remember ever saying? Wait, can I make... Oh, okay. For some reason, I was not paying attention. And was thinking I could change my inventory. Like this screen's color. That would be kind of cool. But alas, we cannot. Okay, does this have a... No. I thought coral was in one of them. Isn't it? I thought it was. Maybe it's just not unlocked yet? Oh well. Get rid of this a while, I guess. Okay, so we need to get more parsnip seeds. So we'll go do that. And, yeah, I guess we'll just take Cracking Knuckles' advice and just kind of keep fishing. Get the fishing level going. Plus, then I can sell a bunch of fish, get a bunch of money. Good stuff. Luna the Third says, do you guys remember the Harry Potter stream, Kida Scream? I highlighted that, so if you ever want to enjoy that, it's in my highlights on Twitch. Make one amethyst colored, one garnet colored, one pearl colored, and one rose quartz colored of the treasure chest, you mean? I also don't think it would be appropriate to call our group the KKK. I don't think that's appropriate. Sass Wonders? Wonder Sass. That'd be like my superhero name. Wonder Sass. Blondies, like the blonde streak in your hair. Slash the delicious dessert. Desserts are delicious. Kitakin is cute. You deserve 10 Kita points for knowing that? Wait, what? What is Super Cheeky Monkey getting? Oh, getting the points from knowing where the quote came from? Yeah, you should get points for that. Holy crap. I can never remember stupid things I've said in videos. Probably gonna get me into trouble at one point or another. Kita feelers? Ew, that sounds like bug feelers. Kita's dream catchers? I don't know, I have a vendetta against dream catchers. Ever since my mom sent me that one she made from prison, it's just like, you know, dream catchers aren't my thing. True story. I thought about sneaking it into my dad's suitcase because I didn't want it. I didn't do that, but I thought about it. I sincerely thought about it. The N7 crew. Sassy pants? Just call you people. The sassies. Instead of Suicide Squad, call us your Sass Squad. We should do Sass Squad, but spell it like S-K-W. Kita Squatters. Sounds like you're living on my lawn. Maurice, why do you have to be such a dickhead? I'm Tour Guide Barbie. On your left, you'll see an indecisive chat. Equi says, I think sassies is simple enough to say. Sounds semi-friendly. Sasquatch. Zextra says, I like sassies. Well, I gotta make sure that it's, like, not too girly because, you know, then guys will be like, oh, I don't want to be called that. Scass Squad. Creepy Jojamart Man. I think that's what I should call you. Creepy Jojamart Man. What a great idea. Kita's cookies or kookies? We're never gonna agree on a name. That's probably true. Kita Sassy Squad. Well, the nice thing is, once I upload this to YouTube, then people who aren't at the stream will get to put in their 2 cents as well. So maybe, I don't know. That'll probably just make it worse, because then there'll be more options. That one's a star oyster, though. I don't think I want to give that to the bundle. Berries! Oh, Allie's back.
Where'd Rue go? Is it just you now? Allie. Allie, what are you doing?
Being lazy. Too many options. The Salt Squad. That's a good one. Again, call us people. Sasquad. It's a good recommendation, Echoey. That won't be hard to spell at all. Something with sass is what Echoey says. Sass-sax? And our t-shirt is just like a picture of a trash bag. With like the word sass on it. Pasta people? What, like Betty Spaghetti? I had a Betty Spaghetti doll. She was kind of weird. All right. Come on, parsnips. We need money. I can't wait to see Pierre beat the crap out of Morris again. Is his name Morris or is it Maurice? I think it's Morris. But I'm very excited. That was like the best cutscene in this whole game. Dreamcatcher says Betty Spaghetti. Oh my god, I forgot that was a thing. Right? It was. I don't think it was like that popular, was it? I don't even know how I had one. Maybe it was because I saw a commercial. My cousin and I were obnoxious little brats and would like scream at the TV when we saw something we wanted for Christmas. It was really obnoxious. I would smack myself. If I could go back in time, I would smack myself. But alas, I cannot. Oh, this cutscene. I get so many cutscenes. John Monroe says, oh my god, some girl on YouTube already calls her viewers glitter knitters. I can't even. See, that sounds like an adult toy. Smiley says, I never had a Betty Spaghetti. I'm so jealous of you. I mean, I don't think sass is girly. I quite like sass in anyone, but I'm just saying I don't want guys to be like... I mean, and maybe they wouldn't care. Zextra doesn't care. But I don't want my male viewers to be like, oh, that's girly. Sassy asses? I mean, that sums it up right there. Sassers? Sassers sounds less feminine than sassies. Weirdly. So that might work. Can't have ass on a high school t-shirt. Just like put an S in front of it with Sharpie. Oh, super cheeky monkey. Goodness. You stay up so late for these streams. D average. Oh, D average. Sassers is definitely less girly than sassies. I don't know. What do you guys think, male viewers? You've been having fresh salads? Have you? Have you? Have you? Creeping on the redhead. Richard Dang says Beanie Babies were my thing when I was a kid. Yeah, and everyone was like, oh, they're going to be so collectible. And sought after, and it's like, yeah, that happened. Kita's Misfits. I thought about calling you guys Misfits, but I don't want people to be like, I don't want it to be a negative thing, like Misfits in a good way, which I think it is, but I wouldn't want like people to be like, ooh. And Brianza Russ says, I actually prefer a girly name. The wise cracks. The Nova 6 is what's Betty Spaghetti. She was like a weird doll that would like bend and stuff. I think she had a friend too, which was also probably pasta related. I don't know. I don't remember. Arctic Snail says, I don't care what you call us. Blazing Storm says, Sass Squad is catchy. Someone said it here. I think we seem to gravitate towards something with sass in it. And I totally agree. It is terrifying. It is kind of terrifying. It's not very pleasing to look at. Chai Moreau says, girl, I'm gay as fuck. Make it as girly as you want. Oh, I love you guys. Cheekers with a K. Zextra says, I'm a straight grown-ass man. Call me Ken or some shit. I don't care. Ken. Call us Betty Spaghettis. Oh my gosh. Echoey says, to be honest, they get turned away because you call your fans sassies. They probably shouldn't be here. You mean if they don't like it? Alright, see you later, blank name. I'll be going till 10, probably, so we got like 40 minutes left. The sassitas. Oh, what John Monroe said. I just think it would help, like, kind of build community, you know what I mean? Because we have, like, a little group that, you know, usually comes to the streams, you know, when they can, and I just think it'd be cool, especially because, like, there's a lot of people on YouTube that play some of the games I play and want to do multiplayer, and I think it would be great if we kind of had a community where, you know, you could be like, oh, I'm playing Animal Crossing, I really wish I had someone to play with, and then there you go. There's somebody, because I don't have the time to play multiplayer with you guys. You know what I mean? I would love to do it, but I don't play a lot of games just on my own. Because a lot of times, you know, it's... I'm actually working. And it is. It is work. A lot of people don't see it that way, but it is, and it's very time consuming. Call us jelly babies. Ah, oh, come on. Just want some treasure, man. Blazing Storm says sassers. No one will forget it with that amount of S with that amount of S's. That's true. The Nova 6 says the Katorians, I remember you saying that in a stream. I think I said that about my Animal Crossing villagers as well. Zextra says, my sister calls me Stephanie. Smiley says, I admit I'm surprised you remembered me. I haven't gone to a stream or commented on a video in a long time, so I appreciate being remembered. I really do try to remember usernames when I see them. It's the problem is when somebody has a different username, like on YouTube, than they do on Twitch or Twitter or something like that, then I'm like, whoa. And it's just, like, I'll always probably associate you by your username, even if you tell me your real name. Like, I might actually know your real name, but I will still probably associate with you with your username. Because that's just kind of how my brain works. Umbreon's Arrest says, you are a fellow stream veteran. We would never forget you. Let the fandom wars begin. Maximize the S game. That's true. It is important to do that. No! I missed it because Instagram sent me a notification. Freaking Instagram. Super Cheeky Monkey says, I got the dinosaur egg by fishing. I wasn't even trying. I was waiting for the blacksmiths to open. You know what? I don't even want to talk to you right now. Richard Dank says, my name is different on Twitter than on here. Yeah, I have to remember that you're the same person. The Nova 6 says, hello, I'm Nova. I just got scared shitless by a leaf. I don't know how you guys got the dinosaur egg. I tried so hard and never got it, so. Oh, I gotta watch my energy, man. Let's go. I don't want to ruin it. Oop. Do you guys know, does anybody know offhand what Sam likes as a gift? I should probably start giving him gifts. Super Cheeky Monkey says, my name is Super Cheeky Monkey on YouTube and Twitch. That is very helpful. It is a lot easier to remember people when they have the same username. Otherwise, I forget. And then it's just awkward and confusing. I'll keep a sunfish. Pretty sure that goes into the thing. And then keep one chub. And I think the bream goes in as well, so. Oh wait, I have a chub over here. Okay. Oh, I'll see you later, Luna the Third. Thanks for stopping by for the stream. We appreciate you spending some time with us. Dreamcatcher Wolf says I have a different username pretty much everywhere. Sam likes Joja Cola too. Oh, okay, cool. He loves pizza. That's good to know. Okay, cool. Alright, level 3 fishing. It's about time! Okay. Awesome. Is it expensive? John Murray says $500 in the saloon. Is it really $500? That's expensive. I don't know if he's worth that. Smiley says, on another note, what is everyone's favorite type of pizza? My favorite type of pizza is probably just cheese. Or I do like white pizza, but again, like with cheese on it, and then some buffalo drizzle. Gee, thanks, Dad. $500. Dad, if you're watching this, send me $500. I could use it. You should totally do this. Subliminal messaging. Wouldn't it be funny if, like, he really did that? That'd be so nice. I could buy me one of those fancy schmancy DX racer chairs so my ass would stop hurting. TMI. It's too late. I already told you. I mean, this chair is pretty good. It's not, like, it's definitely way better than the chair I used to have. I used to have one of those really shitty ones from, like, Staples. Did not do me any favors. Like, this one's way better, but I could use a chair with a little more support on my lower back. Because I am prone to having back problems. Fun stuff. Okay. Everything is watered. How much? I think. Okay. I think what I want to do is get my watering can ready to be upgraded. So I'm going to start making more copper bars. Alright. We'll drop these off at the thing. The thing. And I have to give Jody the cauliflower. Are we good? Okay, we're good. Let's go. Oh, wow. That's a lot. It's a lot of different pizza options. Cam Quinlan says, hey, so what would people want to see us stream this weekend if we do? And the Nova 6 is, I don't actually like pizza all that much. Sacrilege. Super Cheeky Monkey says, I probably won't go to sleep tonight because ever since I had my heart operation, I've been scared my heart would stop. Like I could give myself CPR or something. Oh my gosh. Umbreon Zara says, extra cheese Hawaiian pizza. It's his favorite. Richard Dang likes cheese pizza. John Monroe says, pizza with ham, pineapple, sausage, onion, and jalapenos. Good combination of sweet and spicy. That's a lot of, that's a lot of flavors going on at one time. Arctic Snail says, I like pepperoni pizza. Blankname 2 says, I'm 13 and I have back problems. I actually go to a chiropractor. Oh, wow, that sucks. I don't want to get to that point. Does Jody live in this house or the other house? I think it's the other house. Yeah, this is Haley's house. Stupid. Super Fashion Girl magazine. Sam loves pizza and cactus fruit. He likes any type of gems and beer. Okay. I love all pizzas. Super Cheeky Monkey says, play Outlast or Bioshock. I feel like there's a lot of Bioshock on the channel now, though. Is this Jody? Yes. Here you go. Awesome. Hey, no. I want the money. Yes. Money. Your feet are very important. Please take care of them. That's true. What the heck is on the floor? My cord from my headphones, like, kept touching my foot, and I was like, what the heck is that? Twilight Observer says, I have the wiki up currently. He loves maple bars, pizza, cactus fruit, and tiger's eye. Okay. I'm assuming maple bars is something that you have to cook. Blinkname says Kita doesn't need fashion tips. She's got her own style. Plus, you can't change your outfit in the game. Yeah, my style is garbage chic. I think we've spoken of this before. Oh, right. So Chubb goes in the friendship bundle. Well, we can't really do that right now, can we? Echoey says I have really long feet. Maybe some board tape games like Mario Party? Hmm. If you get 4 hearts with the wizard, you can look in his basement. Oh, you can change your look in his basement. Oh, yeah, because he has, like, a mirror or something that you can use. I wish I could find a good fishing spot. Hey, dude. Why would you think I would destroy your tent? That would be pretty horrible. Maple syrup, sugar, and wheat flour. Wow. Man, Sam's annoying. To woo. Probably just give him a bunch of Joja Cola. Because that's probably easier. Actually, I don't know how much it is, though. Because we're not going to be getting cactus root for a while. $75,000 for Joja Cola. Yeah, that's not bad. We could swing that. Gets changed in an old man wizard's basement is not creepy at all. Yeah, the wizard's kind of creepy. Smiley says, I worked at a well-known monopolized department store where I ruined my feet. Your feet absorb shock when they walk and support your body. My feet roll when they walk. Ooh. Yeah, if you're standing a lot at your job, it just, like, destroys your feet. Especially if the floor is really uncomfortably hard. Wow, that is really tall, Umbreon's RS. But you have tiny hands and feet? You have T-Rex arms? Misa says the first person I married was Sam, not because I like him the most, but because I found him the easiest to woo. Wow, you only care about who's easy, huh? I don't know, Captain Quindolin. What do you want to play when you're down? We could play something spooky for Halloween. I don't know. I have the Xbox set up, so it would be easy to play something on the X-Bone. But I could set something else up, too. What we get? Wow. Exciting! Dreamcatcher Wolf says, 10-hour shifts at a vet clinic kills your knees, hips, feet, and back, especially with the big dogs. Good lord. But you like it, so that's good. Umbranzar says I have normal sized arms, but my hands are small. Do the treasure chests appear more often? Because I feel like I've been seeing them a lot. Come on, fish. Don't be a jerk. What, you playing on the one? I'm confused by that. What do you mean? Like, what am I playing on the Xbox One? That's how I'm playing Bioshock. So I have it set up on my, like, I have a smaller sort of desk next to my, like, where my PC and my monitors are. So I just have the console set up there and it's connected to the Elgato so that I don't have to keep moving it over there. I just have it like set up there. It's just easier. But there's not a lot of room on that desk, so it's kind of annoying to have more than one console set up there. Five Nights at Freddy's. I told you guys, like, I really don't have any interest in playing Five Nights at Freddy's. Plus, I think it's been done to death. Like, there are so many people that have played Five Nights at Freddy's. I don't think that me playing it would add anything to it. You know what I mean? Like, once you've seen it, you've kind of seen it. I just don't think that's a game that it would be that fun to watch a bunch of people play. You could play Costume Quest. I've never played that before. SCP Containment Breach. That's pretty creepy. I've seen that before. Misa says, I hate Five Nights at Freddy's. I think it's stupid. Like, the concept is kind of interesting, which I've said before, like, the animatronics and stuff coming alive is interesting and definitely creepy. I just, it's one of those things that's been so overdone that, plus, I'm not a huge, like, scary game person. It's not that I have anything against them, I just don't really play them that often. That's not really my game of choice. I mean, I probably should try out Resident Evil. I might actually like that series. I don't know. But yeah, I'm just not really a horror gamer. The Halloween Town portions of Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2. Oh my gosh. Kingdom Hearts. I love it so much. Can't wait for 2.8. Really pissed off that it got pushed back. Although you get a cool pin if you pre-order, which is sort of nice. Oh, look, bait. When I don't even have a different fishing rod. Maybe I should go. He's probably not open, though. I should go buy the other fishing rod. I can't remember how much it is. I think it's like 2,500. I could do that. That way I could use bait. When you walk away. Oh no, the theme. Umbreon's Rest says, Costume Quest is an RPG sort of like Stick of Truth, but involves trick-or-treating. Oh, that's cool. It's 1800. Ooh, that's even better. We can only hope. Maybe a Dead Rising game that can be a laugh, also co-op. We might have Dead Rising for Xbox One. I'm not sure. We don't have a lot of Xbox One games. Typically, if a game comes out for PS4 and Xbox One, we get it on PS4. Typically, not always, but like, BioShock I got for Xbox One because I feel like, I don't know, I feel like FPSs kind of feel a little better with the Xbox controller. You're mad there's no Xbox release for Kingdom Hearts? Well, I mean, Square Enix had a deal with Sony. It was a Sony exclusive. I can see why Sony would want to keep it that way because, I mean, I bought a PSP for Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep. That was the literal only reason I bought a PSP. So I could see people buying a PS4 for Kingdom Hearts 3. So I could see why Sony would want to keep it an exclusive. Maybe it'll be one of those things like they did with Tomb Raider where it'll be like an exclusive for a little while and then they'll port it. Dead Rising 2 has been out for ages. Number 3 only came out for Xbox One. Yeah, we might have Dead Rising 3. I'm not sure. John Monroe. Still singing Simple and Clean. I don't know, Captain Quindlin. People are saying Outlast. I think I might have that for Steam. I'm not sure. I don't really want to buy anything. because there's a lot of games coming out soon and they're expensive and I'm poor. Like, we have the Sims expansion coming out. Pokemon Sun and Moon is coming out. That new Harvest Moon game, if I decide to do a video on that, that's coming out. So many games. The Arkham HD collection is coming out. You have the music box version of Simple and Clean on your phone. That's cool. Sanctuary was really good too. Yeah, I agree. It was. Hello, Sebastian, sneaking back home in the dead of night. I just hope that they put a bunch of new worlds in Kingdom Hearts 3. Because so many Disney movies have come out since Kingdom Hearts 2. And they need to be represented. Alright, what garbage is in my pockets? Literal garbage. Okay. Don't need that. That. Yeah, I guess we can sell all the fish. I just have to remember to keep making copper bars because I don't have like 4 of these things anymore. There we go. Oh, shut up. I know you're tired. I don't care. Don't care. Suck it up. We got a lot of fish, though. Craig Knuckles says, if you go to the southernmost area on the second island on the lake, it's the best spot to get silver to gold starfish. Oh, I'll have to check that. I'll have to check that out then. I think I know possibly what you're talking. All the HD remakes, hooray creativity. Yeah, I know, but they're still fun, I think. Plus, you get all the DLC normally, which is cool. So, who remembers No Man's Sky? Umbreon's Arrest says, I want at least 20 worlds versus the normal 12. Yeah, I agree. There should be a ton of fucking worlds for making us wait that long. Like, this is ridiculous. I want them to do Tangled. I want them to do Wreck-It Ralph. Lion King deserves another one, for sure. I'm trying to think now of all the ones that I would want. I'm just gonna be mad if Tangled gets overlooked. Because I feel like it is kind of underrated. And I mean, there could be Pixar in it too now, right? So we could have like Finding Nemo. Hopefully not. We don't need to see Atlantica ever again though. Or anything like Atlantica, please, no. We don't want that. Another Lilo and Stitch world? I agree, that would be cool. It'd be cool if they did like the actual island where they lived instead of just the spaceship. I was glad to see some Lilo and Stitch love, though, in Birth by Sleep. That was nice. Cam Quinlan says, make me play Kingdom Hearts when I'm down. I always forget. I will do that. I love that game so much. So good. Although, it really annoys me that it's so difficult to get the final weapon, or the ultimate weapon in the Final Mix version. Such a pain in the butt. That's why I didn't finish my run-through of it. That was a game I was playing on my own, which I don't normally do. But I was playing that and was trying to get the ultimate weapon, and it was such a huge pain in the butt because, like, just the way that you had to get all the items. Wreck-It Ralph needs a minute? Yes, definitely. It'd be cute to have something with Wally in it as well. I could see, like, a really desolate area for Wally. Like a desolate world. It could work. Twilight Observer says, would you like to see baby slash teenager Kida? I never got the chance to catch Kida's young child, but I was able to grab the other two. Sure. The Nova 6 says, now that I'm older, I went back and rewatching all the classic Disney movies, and they're a lot worse than I remember. I don't know which ones you're referring to. I was never a huge fan of Cinderella or Sleeping Beauty. I did not like Snow White. It kind of creeped me out. Lion King has always been my favorite Disney movie. And I also really love Aladdin and Beauty and the Beast. Okay, thanks, Twilight Observer. I'll check them out then. Arctic Snail says, all that Kingdom Hearts talk is reminding me of which I'll never be able to play. You could play the old ones on PlayStation 2. All of the old ones, the classics, are pretty bad. So, like, are you referring to, like, Sleeping Beauty and Cinderella? Umbreon's Rest says, I want a sword in the stone world. I don't think I ever saw that. Atlantis, The Lost Empire, yes! They should have something with that for sure. Come on, the princess in it is named Kida. She just has a D in her name. Like, of course I would support that. Hey! Is he, like, when does he open? Captain Quinlan just says Atlantis. Hey, like, come on. Does he open at noon? Is that what it is? Or is he just not open on Saturdays? Zootopia, I haven't seen that myself. They'll probably do something with, was it called Inside Out? Is that the one with the emotions? Everything the light touches is part of Kida's kingdom. That's true. John Monroe says, I always wanted to sip tea and talk smack with the three fairies from Sleeping Beauty. That'd be an interesting conversation, for sure. I'm annoyed. I wanted to buy that other fishing rod. Umbreon Zora says, I forgot about Inside Out. He's not open on weekends? Aw, that sucks. That sucks. John Monroe says Inside Out made me cry. Inside Out, like, I went into it thinking it was going to be different than it was, so I think I was disappointed because I kind of thought, like, I didn't expect the story to go the way that it did, and I just ended up being kind of disappointed with it. It's not like I think it's awful or anything. I just remember coming out of it being like, that wasn't as amazing as I thought it was going to be, sort of thing. As much as I love Amy Poehler, it's not really what I expected. The Nova 6 is yes, Cinderella, Snow White. Yeah, I never really liked them to begin with, so I mean, Snow White just kind of creeped me out. Although I think Ursula was the scariest Disney villain for me. Oh yeah, Toy Story. That could be interesting. Maybe they would just have like a whole world that's just Pizza Planet. That'd be pretty cool. Is this the area that you meant, Cracky Knuckle? For the silver and gold fish? Inside Out did have an amazing cast. I agree. And Brian Zara says, I also want Bambi. That could be a really sad time, though. What was your least favorite Kingdom Hearts world? Besides Atlantica. Because everyone hates Atlantica. Because it's awful. Good lord. Oh, alright, see you later, Arctic Snail. Thanks for stopping by. Brian Zara says, I just want to see if they make Bambi's mama heartless. I'm trying to think of what my least favorite world was. I didn't really like Alice in Wonderland. I found that world kind of annoying. Craig Nook says, that is one of the areas that grants gold stars at higher fishing levels. Is it this one right here? But in the northern lake is the one I used a lot for fishing. Is that... Are you referring to the one by the Adventurers Guild? The lake by the face? The cave. Oh, okay. Umbreon Zara says, I really like dislike Tarzan's world. Yeah, I agree. Plus, the Clayton boss fight is really stupid, especially if you're not ready for it. Like, if you go to Tarzan's world first instead of Alice in Wonderland, you're really not prepared for that fight. You love Atlantica and Kingdom Hearts 2? You're lying. You have to be lying. I don't believe you. I'm Brian Zaras. I think another world that I found really annoying was Hollow Bastion. Because of all... Like, if you were trying to get all the treasure chests and stuff, it is a pain in the ass to mess around with all the mechanisms to get it. John Minoris is Tarzan's world. Hashtag nope. Well, we don't have to worry about that because they would have to get special permission to do Tarzan again. Because of the copyright, so I highly doubt we'll see anything with Tarzan again, so you don't have to worry about it. That world is annoying, though, because you... I don't think you have, like, double jump or anything by that point, so when you're trying to hop on the hippos, that part can be annoying. Haha. John Monroe. Cam Quillen says, oh my god, the vines. Famous Crazy Mai, I think that's how you pronounce that, says, hello, I just found your YouTube channel. I really do enjoy your sense of humor. I do find you quite entertaining. Well, thank you. And Branzara says, no, I really liked it. I hated the controls in Kingdom Hearts 1, but liked the rhythm games in 2. Oh my gosh, I hated Atlantica so much. The songs were so bad. Oh yeah, Mulan's world was good. Mulan's world was really good, actually. I would like to see more of Mulan in Kingdom Hearts 3. I think that movie's underrated. Well, we'll have to try the Northern Lake then. See if I can get lucky over there. Although, wow, we only caught 5 fish. That's pretty bad. Blank name says you have good taste. Equi says, did I miss anything? No, we were just talking about which worlds we like and don't like in Kingdom Hearts. As I was fishing. That's pretty much all you missed. Not too much. Just chillin'. You can... Oh, you're talking about Pokemon Mystery Dungeon. I was gonna say, someone said you can play them on the Wii U. I'm like, you can't play Kingdom Hearts on the Wii U. But now I know what you mean. Alright, how did I get copper? I don't remember actually getting copper. Okay. I still have some energy left, so I think I'm gonna chop down some trees. Just gonna chop down all the trees. Camp Quinlan says, I only got a question right in Quiz Bowl practice today because of the Pocahontas movie. Really? What was it? It was like, what was her father's name in history? And I remembered because of the movie. They actually used his real name in the movie. That's surprising. Blank Name says, I like the Wii U for the sole fact that it is used for emulations. It is pretty nice that they put so many games on there so that people can experience them, especially if they never really had the chance to do it before. Who's my favorite YouTuber? That's really hard. It kind of depends because there are a lot of YouTubers that are in different like niches, so it's kind of hard to compare someone who does reviews versus somebody who does let's plays versus somebody that does like comedy sketches, you know what I mean? Like, it's sort of hard to compare those when they're different categories. I could tell you some of my favorite YouTubers. Obviously, yeah, my favorite YouTuber is myself. Let's just be real. That's not narcissistic. Blank Name 2 says, I know every Pokemon movie in existence that is official. Oh, wow. It's a very specific skill set. Alright guys, it is 10 o'clock and we just ended the day, so I feel like it's a good place to end the stream. But thank you guys for coming and hanging out. If you're watching this in the future on YouTube, I do stream every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. We do chill streams, very relaxed. And right now we're playing Stardew Valley, so you should totally come and check us out. Put up my little end screen there. But, yeah, I... Echoey says, we are sassers. She's putting it in there. Dies Alone says, alright, good night. Remember death to Shane. Why must good things end so early? Because it's been going for 3 hours, and my throat is starting to tickle. And I have yet to find